All right, then let's try to resume. We've got what does data tell us? Current figures: 315 kilometers left for fuel. Okay, that is something actually else, but okay, that was. Sorry, everything here isn't actually by the steering wheel. So we got trip 2, 15 kilometers, no, 350, trip 1, 26, 6.6 average, and trip 2, 15 kilometers per hour average, of course. 10 liter per 100, so almost one. Echo is on right now. It's yes, average is 4.8 or 9.51 right now. Almost 80, and an average we have is on 8 liters per 100 kilometers. But the echo mode is, you know, still on, so that you can save in many liters. And I can see that on the consumption after 91 kilometers that I've probably not driven that hard, neither very soft, but yes, just in between, maybe 141 kilometers to Kristiansand. I mentioned something about the automatic transmission system. I mean, of course, everything is automatic, but we're now in we have in the sixth gear, and we have 80 kilometers, but. I would almost prefer for motorway driving that it could be sixth gear as well, because somehow it isn't that fast on acceleration when it comes to, you know, coming ahead in slopes, if you understand. Downwards it's tip top, like it is right now. You can just check that environment or scenery. 105, 100 right now. And you have to almost break up because of these cars driving in front of us. And there is a Chiatara 4 in front of us right now. Typical two-wheeler, four-wheel drive. Being used on these roads, but yeah, I think if it was a bit smaller car, a station wagon or a Passat or Audi or Volkswagen or something like that. Mercedes, of course, Audi and all that. They would move a bit faster, probably. I have to unclog my ears a bit. Down fast rapidly, and here we have now we are down at sea level, probably 5-10 meters over sea level. Behind me, I have actually, I think it's a Suzuki X-Cross or something like that. You see that many Mitsu Outlanders, hybrid cars, vehicles on these roads. And it's like, you know, Land Cruisers and Hilux and Toyotas are actually used by for utility purpose, while in other countries they are VIP cars and all that. Average 6.6, new average 0.5 actually. Yeah, but that was high winter types actually. 5.3, 5. Suzuki Across. I just slowed up a bit to actually give you the data, and then an extra Suzuki Across and go to front. Yeah, so right now zero consumption. Right now we have 1.4. It's so typical that now that we are 100 kilometers south from Stavanger, and we have Scotland actually by our right side, if you're wondering, it typically always rains here. Has to do with the there are rivers and fjords, not only because of the one to left, but because of the geography we have here. That. Is actually part of South Europe. And, we are at the border of Agder, out of Rogaland County, in 2 kilometers. Thank you. again for this little town. There are actually many, many towns in Norway, not exactly cities, just to have you with me on that. New Circle K, or sorry, XY station. Side. Yeah, I've been stopping here for L-car charging, and just to take you with me on further trips, I'm also counting or estimating the distance from or between charging stations. Not that I can also do that by measuring up on maps and with that road planning calculators or map views and all that, but to have experienced this in exact kilometers or miles actually helps a bit, because you never know, is it winter, is it summer, do you have winter tires, summer tires, are you driving in a queue like this, like today, or not. So so the trip is almost 200 kilometers one way, and I'll try not to stop up the video recording to give you live, almost live update, but because I'm following road trips myself, I have a very active Tesla beyond Nyland, around the Oslo area, and he's sort of driving from Oslo to a bit northern parts of Norway, and then from Oslo to Sweden and Denmark, and to Germany as well, with different cars. Because of these villages and towns, we just lose quite much of that speed, or at least I would say somewhat. Anyways, what do you think about the landscape? Beautiful, isn't it? It's of course nice, it is. Yeah, and the speed of throttles are hand gear shafts are actually meant to gear down like this whenever the traffic is running at 60 and not 80 kilometers. Negative aspect of these roads here is that there are frequent accidents, many in a year, and this year of 23 has also been dramatic, drastic numbers of both road accidents and casualties. There, we are out of our region, and you can see now that the North Sea towards UK Sea and all that has visible. Radio.